Hello again. Welcome back to Rants and Reels. This is Kyle, and I'm on my way to go see a movie. I'm going to see Red Sparrow. Red Swallow. No, Red Sparrow. The heartwarming story of a Russian ballerina forced into spy work? I don't know. But it looks interesting. So we're gonna see how this is, and I'll be back in just a minute, and I'll tell you what I thought. Just walked out of that theater. It is long. This is a long movie, and okay, there's quite a bit here. I'm going to show you the trailer, because that's going to be important for what I have to say next. So watch the trailer. I'll be right back.
Honey, Mama.
What is it?
I have to go away for a while. I was told to take a man to a hotel. They said that he was an enemy of the state.
Take off your dress.
And in exchange, my mother would get the doctor she needed. Instead, they cut his throat. There could be no witnesses. So they gave me a choice. Die or become a sparrow.
From this day forward, you will become sparrows. Weapons in a global struggle for power. You'll be trained in psychological manipulation. You must learn to push yourself beyond all limitation. Take off your clothes. When we are finished with you, the person you were will no longer exist. Every human being is a puzzle of need. You must become the missing piece, and they will tell you anything.
You have a gift. You know how to survive. This is what you were meant to do. There is a traitor in the government. His last known contact is an American. Get close to him.
I thought I saw you in the pool yesterday.
Are we going to become friends?
Is that what you want?
She's a sparrow.
You only matter because of what you can do for them. Work with me and make these men pay.
You are better at this than any of us. Your only problem is you have a soul.
We can't trust a word that comes out of her mouth.
There's something else. We're not seeing it.
If she's compromised, she will be eliminated.
What have you done?
You belong to them. They'll never let you go.
I'll find a way.
So you watched that trailer. And what would you have thought that... What would you think that movie is? It looks like an action spy thriller. Like, it's like gonna be a kick-ass, like, Black Widow. You know, she's gonna turn into this badass that's gonna take down all the bad guys or good guys or whatever. That's not what this is at all. This is a very long, now it's like 2.5 hours, like 2 hours, 20 minutes. It's drawn out, and it is paced agonizingly slow. There is very little action that takes place here. There is very little action that takes place in this movie. It is a drawn out, very meticulously constructed like mystery, kind of. It is a spy movie, but in the espionage sense, it is very thick as far as plot goes, and just as forewarning for anybody still considering watching this movie, which it's not a bad movie, so I'm not really going to discourage anybody from watching this. But be aware, it is very rapey. There is a lot of sexual content, and it is not always consensual. So if you have trouble at all watching rape scenes or sexual coercion, those things, it made me a little uncomfortable watching that. I'm not generally one, and it sounds kind of horrible to say this out loud now that I think about it. Watching that on screen, knowing in the back of my head, not really the back, but in the front of my head, in my head, I know it's not real, it's a fictitious depiction, it doesn't really get to me. Not something I'm going to seek out. So, just forewarning, if that makes you uncomfortable, if you don't want to see that, you know, that's your trigger warning for anybody, because I sure would have liked to have known that was coming to that extent before I sat down and watched that movie. I also would have really liked that movie to have been sold in the advertising, in the trailers, for what it is. It is a very slow, long, drawn out. It's basically a mystery suspense film, which is fine. Now it was filmed wonderfully. It was very well shot, very well filmed, very well performed, so no complaints there. The story was even interesting. It was just way too long. It felt like it took ages, and there was a lot in there that they could have easily cut a good 45 minutes out of that runtime and had a much, much faster paced narrative. So it was hard to watch. That's what the roundabout thing I'm trying to get to is, that was a hard movie to watch. Even when I was interested, I couldn't shake the feeling of, you know, hey, get on with it. Okay, we get what's happening. We get it. You can move on to the next step. We don't need these long, drawn-out shots. And now it's especially tedious, and I hate to use the word tedious when it comes to a film score, especially one that was this gorgeous. The music was just beautiful, but oh my God, it was like a sedative when nothing's happening and you have long drawn out shots and you have this music that is just a little repetitive and very melodic. Yeah, no, this is... Look, I wouldn't blame anybody if they fell asleep in that movie. I'm not entirely convinced I didn't fall asleep in that movie, but I also didn't miss anything, because I followed the whole thing without problem. There were some people who wound up showing up, 20 minutes into the film, 30 minutes into the film, and they didn't miss anything. They followed the entire story. They got it. There was no need to, catch them up after on what they missed in order for it all to make sense and play out. So, yeah, it needed a heavy hand in the editing room, I think. And it needed restraint. It really needed restraint. And this is not the awesome, female-led spy film you want. If you want that, go back to Atomic Blonde that we had last year. That's what you're looking for. This is not that. This is not that at all. That was an endurance run. That was an endurance run, and I feel a little... I just feel uncomfortable, and nothing against Jennifer Lawrence at all, but I feel like I owe her an apology for watching that. It feels like I invaded her safe space just watching that, which is a ridiculous notion and a ridiculous feeling to have, but there it is. And I'm gonna call it there. Red Sparrow, a good story, a solid story, and a very well-made film, and man, the cast just performed the hell out of it. They knocked it out of the park, but too long, lingered too much on the sexual assault, and that made me not feel okay walking out of that. So, yeah, I'm calling it there. Thanks for watching, and everybody have a good night. I'll see you next time.